can, please follow us on social media. We are on Twitter and Facebook, and we do our best to keep people up to date with what's happening in Catalonia. At the end of today's meeting, if you can stay on, please do. We are going to do a photo with the panel and some flags that we can make to have as many of you in that photo as possible. Over the last 10 years, Catalonia has really become my second political home. I've had the chance to visit a number of times and to find out about the nation's long and proud history, about the importance of the Catalan language and culture, and to be inspired by the mass movement that Alan spoke about the appeal that has been made to both head and heart that has become so important in the modern battle for self-determination. Now, we know that democracy is supposed to be fluid. It's meant to ebb and flow to the will of the people, unless those people happen to be Catalans. I found that in my last two visits to Catalonia, on the 9th of November in 2014 for their consultative referendum, and again last year for the 27th of September elections to the Catalan Parliament, the majority of Catalan people took a pro-independence position. So it's clear, to borrow a phrase from Scottish politics, that the settled will of the Catalan people is for independence, but it is also depressingly clear that the settled will of the Spanish government is to ignore that view no matter what. And I think it's this impasse that is perhaps the biggest difference in our two campaigns, because we know that for all its flaws that we live in a democracy, apart from the abominations of the House of Lords and perhaps a voting system that we don't always agree with in terms of first past the post, but we know that for all those flaws and faults, that the UK Prime Minister would have accepted a yes vote in our referendum, because it was laid out in the Edinburgh Agreement agreed before the referendum. But an agreement like this would never be possible in Catalonia. I could scarcely believe how popular David Cameron was on my visits to Catalonia. He enjoys a near hero status. Not quite in the same league as Lionel Messi, but I think not far from it. And that's because Cameron took a decision that Mariano Rajoy, or whoever becomes the next Prime Minister of Spain, could never take. And the reason for that is simple, that Spain knows that if allowed a free and unfettered vote to decide their own futures, then the people of Catalonia would vote for independence, and Spain would lose its most profitable region, the engine of its economy. As you might expect, Spain's stubborn refusal to even negotiate with Catalonia has helped to galvanise the political support for self-determination in Catalonia over the last few years, meaning that Catalan independence enjoys a breadth of political support. And I think it's important for us here to realise that while the majority of support for independence in Scotland comes from the political left, that in Catalonia, pro-independence support can be found across the political spectrum, from the centre-right Convergencia, who under the leadership of Artur Mas developed a stronger independence stance, to our friends in the Republican left from Esquerra, who, like the SNP, have been at the vanguard of campaigning for independence since the 1930s. But most interestingly, it's not the political parties or the politicians who set the agenda in Catalonia, it's the people. It's the mass mobilisation of Catalan citizenry that has been so inspiring to watch and so incredible. I think one of the most incredible feats in modern politics. And we've all been inspired when we see the pictures from Catalan National Day, as millions of people take to the streets, singing, chanting, and smiling their ways to the edge of history. I'll admit that when I travelled to Barcelona in November 2014, that I was still, like everyone here, utterly shattered by our referendum process. But being in towns, big towns like Barcelona or small towns like Vic or in Girona, witnessing the enthusiasm that people had there for Scotland's process helped to re-energise me and to give me a renewed sense that our journey to independence is far from over. I think we can learn a lot about that civic movement, and with the First Minister's announcement yesterday of a renewed campaign for independence, I think that we should try to find ways of harnessing the civic energy that is so important and so vital in Catalonia's process. So in closing my remarks, friends, the next 18 months will be an extremely interesting time in both Catalan and Scottish politics. While we will be campaigning in May's elections and then in the EU referendum and then the very important local government elections in 2017, Catalonia's Parliament will be continuing the work on its roadmap to independence and to statehood. And so the SNP Friends of Catalonia will endeavour to do all that we can to support these campaigns both at home and in Catalonia as we continue our long journeys as they reach the last few miles on the road to independence. Thank you very much.